Now, in 2016, only 12 countries in Africa had parliamentarians below the age of 30. Of those 12, the place of women in spaces of leadership remained constricted. Despite the continent hosting the youngest population aged between 15 and 35, a lot still needs to be done to expand the leadership opportunities for both genders. The AU says it's working with member states through its governance architecture to open more windows of opportunity for women to fully participate in politics in their respective countries.
We have a long way to go. You can think about small countries like Rwanda, Mozambique and Senegal who are doing well. But if you look at the 54 countries that are on the continent, we have so many other countries that are not, that are doing poorly still. But it's a progressive step, and we also have to take those steps. And the fact that we are recognizing that we have a long way to go, I think this is the first step we should take. And yes, I think it's time to start thinking beyond the number. One of our aim is to create citizen engagement. So one of the components, the major components that we are engaged in is creating that citizens engagement space for women, young people, and men, including the media and civil society organizations, to also have that spaces. And by doing so, we want to make AU citizens organization.
All these gender bias kind of languages were used towards me, not because I could not do the job, not because I have less potential than the male contestant, but just because I'm a woman. So there's a lot that we, the young women in Africa, do face. But what I should actually tell the young people out there is for them to start early. It's good for them to start early. You get to know, you get to experience all this at a younger age, and you have time to fight until you get to whatever point that you want.